PPT of the first module with you. I'll share the slide. So here we are discussing about various types of research in the context of business research design. So some concepts may be repetition, as we have already discussed different types of research. Okay, but now here we are clearly classifying the different types of research. So that is our main discussion in this module. So if you see the research classification, research design classification, we see broadly two types of research. One is exploratory research design, the other one is conclusive research design. One is exploratory research, another is conclusive research. Under conclusive research, we have descriptive research and causal research. Under descriptive research, we have further two types, that is cross-sectional design and longitudinal design. Under cross-sectional, we have further two types, that is single cross-sectional studies and multiple cross-sectional studies. So we will try to discuss about these different types of research one by one. So exploratory research design means, as we have discussed earlier already about this, so exploratory research is done when we have to gain some more insights into a particular area. So you are interested in particular research, you want to do a research in particular area, but you do not have much idea about it. So what it is, you just know the area. Okay, say I'm telling you now, so employee turnover. So you know what is the meaning of employee turnover. So you know that it is the employees resigning from the job or leaving from the job and going. So that term in HR is called as employee turnover. So you may be interested in doing research in this particular area, but you don't know how to do it. What are the variables involved in that study? You don't know how to do the study. What methodology I have to adopt, whether I have to depend on primary data, whether I have to depend on secondary data, which type of research I have to do. Okay, so that's what we are discussing here. You know, I have to do a causal research, descriptive, what type of research? So many questions will be there in your mind, right? So how do you get answers for all these questions? So you have to do exploratory research. So every researcher in the beginning, he will have to do exploratory research to get more insight into the area of his research. Okay, so that is called as, so the purpose is to make your doubts clear, to clear your ambiguity. You are doing exploratory research. So it is simplest form of research. It is very simple. This type of research, exploratory research, is done very simple, and it is unstructured research design. There is no formal structure as you have to do this, after that next this. So such steps are not there. You may go back to any step and do it in your own way. Okay, so problem definition is not there here. You need not define what is a problem. Okay, you go on doing, collecting data and getting more information in that particular area. So that's why it's loosely structured design. There is no clear cut as what and how you have to do. So it is done to do explore. You want to know more, to obtain more clarity for the problem situation. So as I said already, So your area is employee turnover, so maybe in particular industry, manufacturing industry, the employee turnover in manufacturing industry, you are studying, there is a problem area. So how I have to go about this? What variables I have to include in my study? How should I define the problem? What type of data I have to collect? How much time it may take? So all these questions will be answered if you are doing exploratory research. So it is a flexible research. There is no very structured design here. So you can go and do one step and you can go back to the other step, previous steps. Mostly it involves collecting of qualitative data. So this particular research is mainly dependent on qualitative data. There is no much quantitative data involved in this particular research. Sample size is not representative. So as you know, if you are involved in primary data collection for this particular research, then you will have to get a sample. You have to have a sample size. So in sample size, there is something called as representative sample. Representative sample means, so as you have some idea, so sample means small portion of the population, and this small portion, when you are taking sample, it should be a good sample, then it should be a representative sample. Representative means this sample should have all the characteristics of the population from which you are taking the sample. Got it? So here again, don't misunderstand with the term population. So population does not mean the population of a particular country or a region. So in research, population means the total number of consumers related to that particular study, if it is related to consumers or employees or elements. Say for example, you are doing a HR study, as I said, say employee turnover, you want to do a study in a particular industry, say manufacturing industry. So in all the employees of the manufacturing industry becomes your population. Got it? So if you are taking sample of this, that sample will be smaller in size compared to the whole population. So you cannot collect the data from the whole population, practically not possible. All the employees of manufacturing sector, how will you collect? Time is not sufficient, cost is not there, you cannot bear the cost. Okay, so this is the issue. So you'll have to take a, and it's not necessary also. So if you take a representative sample, that is sufficient. So representative sample, as I said already again, it is about the sample that you take from the population should be having all the characteristics of the whole population. So that is called as representative sample. It involves unstructured interview with a few subjects. Maybe you are doing a exploratory research by doing some unstructured interviews. Unstructured means there is no proper way of asking one certain questions. In interview, normally it can be a structured interview or unstructured interviews. So this is done to collect data, so exploratory research. So structured interview is where you are going to ask one question and then next question, third question, fourth question, fifth question. Everything is clear. It is there already. So that is structured interview. Unstructured question interview is there where you are not, defining what question to be asked after the other, one after the other. No, you are going on asking as you are having a discussion. So that is called as unstructured interview. So it involves unstructured interview with a few subject experts. So it may be that you are doing an discussion with some experts in that particular area. For example, this particular area, as I said, you are going to do a research on the employee turnover in manufacturing sector. So you don't know what much about it. So what you have to do, you have to sit with the experts who know it, who are having some more information than you in that particular area. Maybe HR people, human resource managers of manufacturing industry. So if you discuss with them, if you have some unstructured interview with them, about at least some 10 people, if you interview, you will get some more idea. So that is that. Okay. Also, you may go through some secondary data resources. Secondary data resources, as we have done already, literature survey. So you may do literature survey. Already some articles that is there published in this particular area. So employee turnover in manufacturing sector, already there will be so many articles. So you read that, understand it, what it is. Okay. So that type of secondary, so that is called as secondary data resources. So you may depend on secondary data resources for doing expert research. That may be there. Some more thing. So some more secondary data analysis, what it can be done, what are the other resources? Previously collected facts and figures. Company records. Company will be having a records of the employees. So that you can check how many people were recruited in a particular year, how many people left the job in a particular year. For past 10 years, you can collect it. Is it not? So that will show some idea on the employee turnover. So different industries, you can collect some database, maybe there in the HR department. So that can be done, authenticated and published. And whenever you are depending on articles or other secondary sources, you should ensure that that is, you know, authenticated. It is from an authorized source. That's why we are, you know, when you are doing literature survey, I was answering why you have to do it in Google Scholar, not in Google. Google Scholar authenticates the articles that has been published, right? So you can know that it is not simply written without any facts. So that is whatever articles are based on proper procedure and proper way of analyzing data is there, and they have collected in a proper, through the proper source. Got it? So that you can rely on that, and it is published. The article should be published. And this type of secondary data is easier and less expensive than collecting primary data. It may lead to further experimental conclusive research. So normally experimental research is not an end, it is just the beginning. And this exploratory research may further lead to different type of research. So it is just a foundation, a beginning for other type of researches that you are planning to do. Comprehensive case study method. So here in exploratory, there is some comprehensive case study method also, which means that you are doing an in-depth study of a single unit. It can be an employee. So you are doing a study about an employee, his behavior, one person, one employee. Okay, his nature of work, his stress level. If you're doing that, but so only you're studying about one employee, that becomes a comprehensive case method. Or it may be about one product, its sales analysis. Okay, product analysis. You are going to do that particular related to one product, then it becomes a comprehensive case method. Or it may be related to one company or one country. So that is called as comprehensive case study method. And maybe that you may do exploratory research through primary data also. So we are discussing about how exploratory research is done through secondary data. Exploratory research may be done through primary data also. How it is done? Expert opinion survey. So you may collect interview from the experts, through the experts who know more than who are expert in that particular field. Employee turnover. So you may ask, as I said already, you may conduct a depth interview with the HR managers of that particular industries. If you don't have any other information available, then you can adopt this techniques. So this is one of the method, depth interview. It will be, say, you are conducting depth interview for maybe 40, 45 minutes with the HR manager. So you may ask him several questions related to the employee turnover. So that will give you some information. Focus group discussions. You may conduct focus group discussions with the employees. So respondents, you may select, identify maybe 6 to 10 people, ranging from 6, minimum 6, maximum 10 people. And you may ask them to discuss on their turnover intention. Employee, why, why people are leaving the organization. Employee turnover, just give them the topic employee turnover and let them discuss for 90 minutes, 90 to 2 hours, 90 minutes to 2 hours, the discussion will be there. And it is in a natural setting. There is no artificial setting. It may be like a classroom or a conference room where 6 people are sitting or 10 people are sitting and they are given the topic and they are freely discussing about this particular topic. And points are noted by the observer, the person who is doing the research or observing, he will go on noting the points what the individual members are contributing. So that is called as focus group. The time is, it may be up 90 minutes minimum or maximum 2 hours. Okay, that is called as focus group discussions. So that is for today, and that was about the exploratory.